Today we're going to talk about how to install the TMC2209 on the Bigtree Tech SKR Pro version 1.2. So I'm going to zoom in on the actual stepper here to show you what's going on. Over here we have a TMC2209 and it's version 1.2. And as you can see, there's an enable pin located right over in here. That's going to be relevant in just a moment. But on the other one, I have cooling fins. I have to warn you in advance, you need to keep the cooling fins on it just to keep it cool. And a cooling fan is recommended as well. So on the board, what we need to now do is actually figure out what position to put the jumpers in order to run the stepper. So I'm going to show you that real quick. We're actually going to go over to the web page for the actual configuration and figure out what needs to be set. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring up the web page and show you what you need to know. So here we go. Over here we have the Bigtree Tech for the SKR Pro version 1.1, but there's a subfolder for the SKR Pro 1.2. In here you'll find the manual, and then you can open up the manual right here. So this basically explains the board very quickly, so I'm going to scroll through a lot of this because you can read this on your own time. And as you can see, as I get down here, I want to explain this. This is for USB power. And I'll point this out on the board in just a moment, but we're gonna need to be on direct power because the steppers will not function correctly if we are not. So let's scroll down a little bit further here. And what we're looking for is we're gonna find out that this is the X stepper, Y stepper. The Z stepper has two ports that you can plug into. Then we have E0, E1, and E2 for extruders. Now, also I need to point out that there's a motor power and then a direct power. And as you can see, it can be 12 or 24 volts. So down here, what we're gonna look at is actually the power setup. And this particular configuration right here is the step direction mode. We're not gonna be using that, we're gonna be using UART. And we're also going to be doing sensorless homing. So here's the UART mode, and the jumper position is right here. So we're going to go back to the board and set this up. So on the board, we need to remove these jumpers because they're not for this particular configuration. And once we have them out, what we're going to then do is connect the jumper over here for UART and push that down. Now what we can do is actually examine this and see that there's one color on one side being red and then black and then pins in the front. So we know how to configure this by just dropping it in right here. So that's all you have to do for the setup there. Next we actually need to load the firmware. Pardon me. So I have this little device that I need to use to connect to my computer. It's a Rocket Tech. So I'm going to pop out the drive. And just so you know, no one's paying me or sponsoring me to do this tutorial, but I will place Amazon affiliate links in the description for your convenience. So that's now on the computer. So let's go over and see what we need to set up in VS Code. So inside VS Code, what we need to now do is actually load the configuration. So I'm going to show you how to do that. Let me just change this so you can see better. So I'm going to click on the Explorer, then I'm going to click on Open Folder. I'm going to go to my Downloads folder where I've already downloaded the Marlin current firmware and extracted it. And I'm going to go in the first Marlin folder, then the second, and say Select Folder. Inside here, what I'm then going to do is I'm going to go to the Marlin folder, the source folder, then the core folder, then boards.h. insideboards.h, I'm going to search on SKR underscore pro. And our version of our board is right here, so I'm going to copy this. Then I'm going to close out of boards.h. I'm going to minimize the folder and the source, and then go over to configuration.h. Inside configuration.h, I'll search on motherboard, and I'll highlight the ramps board and paste over that. Next, I need to set the serial port, so I'm going to say -1. That's for our serial communication that we'll need for our computer. And then we need to set up the stepper, so I'm going to search on A4988. That'll bring us to where we need to be. For the X stepper driver, I'm going to remove the comment. Then I'm going to copy the TMC2209, and I'm going to paste that over the A4988. That's all you have to do to set that up on this particular thing. You may have to set a couple of other things depending upon which direction you want your sensorless homing to go, but I'll show you that in a moment. So what we have here is 80. This is for access steps per unit. So we need to understand something real quick here. So I'm going to go to the advanced configuration and search on 800. And I'm going to scroll down to here. And this value being 16 is tied to the other value. So if this is 80, if you change this to 160, you're going to need to change this to 32. And if you change this to 320, then you need to change this to 64, and so on and so forth up to the maximum number of steps per unit that you can do. It's between 0 and 256th of a step. So once that's configured, I'm going to go back over here and I'm going to search first on TMC underscore debug. And you'll see why in a few moments, but I'm going to remove the comment here. And I'm going to find the second one and do the same. This allows us to use G codes so that we can then do testing. In this case, we're going to be using the M122. But now we have to set up sensorless homing. So I'm going to search on sensorless. And as you can see, we have sensorless homing right here. So I need to remove the comment. In order to use it, we need to set a sensitivity level. And as you can see up here for the TMC2209, it's between 0 and 255. So the most optimal one I've found is 125, seems to work best. So I'm going to go back over to the configuration.h and show you the invert just in case you need it. So if we go to invert, you'll see down here that you can change the direction. If it's not going to the direction that you would like, you can change the false to a true and the true to a false to address that. But for now, I'm just going to leave it alone. So I'm going to go over to platformio.ini to prepare to build this. And as you can see, the default environment right now is the Mega 2560. So we need to search on the SKR underscore pro to find our default environment. So I'm going to copy that. And then I'm going to scroll up to the top and paste it right here. Now, the other thing we need to do is actually do a clean so that we make sure we're not going to use the wrong build, because obviously I do a lot of builds. So it cleans out this folder for you. So now we can actually click the build button to build it. And if there's any issues, it'll pop up during the build and we can address those. So this looks like it's going pretty good at the moment, but now it's failing. So what we can do is we can look at this, and if it's something that doesn't make sense like this, hit the build button again. If you do have an error that causes a cascade of other errors, fix the very first error you encounter, because the other errors may be related to that issue. So while this is building, you can see that the .pio folder is populating. And this folder is where our build will end up for firmware.bin. So I'll show you what happens after it finishes. So it's pretty close right now. So there it is. So we'll right click on that and then we'll go to reveal in File Explorer. Then we'll right click again and we'll say send to the D drive. And on the D drive, what you can see is there's a firmware.cur in all capital letters. And then there's a lowercase one that ends in .bin. The bottom one is a current folder, or excuse me, current build that was once loaded. And this is the one that we're going to load. So if it's successful, it'll rename it to this. So what I'm gonna do now is go back over to the motherboard and we're gonna prepare it a little bit more. So first I'm gonna pop out the drive. I'm gonna place the drive in here, but we also have to set up power, which currently is unplugged. So we need to set up the power for the steppers. So I'm gonna open that up. And as you can see, I've marked the top of the bolts with red for voltage. So I'm gonna screw those down. And then the other one that's unmarked is gonna be for ground. And I'll tighten that down. And then I'll do the same for the board power. So I'll plug this in. Tighten it down. And then finally this one for the ground. And tighten that down. Now I'll close that for safety. So we're all set there. Now I also need to plug in the actual stepper. So I'm gonna plug it in over here with the DuPont connector. And we're all set for using this now. So I'm gonna plug this in first. It's not powered, but it will turn on a light. And I'll plug in this so that we can load the firmware. So you'll see a green flashing light. That's the actual flashing occurring. And once that's complete, we're gonna go over to Pronterface to test it. So inside Pronterface, currently it says COM port 1, and then there's another one that says 17. I am unsure if that's the correct one, so I'll show you how to check it. So if you go over to Device Manager and open this up, what you'll see is that there is a COM port 17, so it confirms what we're looking for. So I'll close that. I'll pull the drop down over here and say connect. And as you can see, it says connecting, and then it says printer is now online. So to test the actual stepper, because it's plugged in, we're gonna type the M122 G code and press enter. And as you can see, it says that it's okay. So we're gonna go back over and we're going to test it now. So I'm gonna move it 10. And so you can see that it's moving 10. Now I'm gonna home it. So now it homes fine. So what we've learned from this is that we can actually move the access, no problem. And we can also home it with no problem. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe. And thank you for your time.